All right, welcome to the loudest van I've ever driven. There's not a lot I can do about it. One day I'll clean it a little bit and it might make a little less noise. But that's not today. Anyway, so this video is not going to be something different because I've done a video like this one before. It was the previous situation was kind of worse, but regardless. So this is going to be a kind of review, post-mortem. Only one character died. Just review of a session or mission, adventure, whatever you want to call it, that went poorly for the party. For reference, because, you know, I'm mostly making this video to send to the actual other players in this campaign. But for reference, this is my formerly Curse of Strahd game. It's now Second Coming of the Night Parade, Dendar stuff, Elder Evil, and we're still currently in the character spotlights, where everyone takes what's going to be their main character, and we do a short adventure centered around that character. This is the fourth one. And the character in question is the human mercy monk Sibba, who is also otherwise a brand new character. He was in one of the earlier spotlights, but other than that, that was it. He was brand new in that, and the spotlight he was in really didn't have much combat, so there wasn't much of a chance to really test him out. And building monks is a little tricky. It can be difficult because unless like your stats are really good, there's not a whole lot you can do with them at higher levels. Like you can give them the crusher feat, and you're really dependent on one, your DM giving you the few monk items, like Dragonhide Belt, Insignia of Claws, Eldritch Claw Tattoo, and I think there's like new hand wrap items from the Book of Many Things or something, but that's just official stuff. It's really dependent on the DM either handing out highly specific monk items that otherwise nobody's going to use, or it's dependent on the DM homebrewing some monk items, you know, like a pair of brass knuckles that do extra fire damage, you know, because a monk is going to scale a little better with extra damage per hit than other classes will, just because of the frequency of more attacks, until you get into, you know, level 20, and then the fighter is just doing as many attacks as you are for no resources. But that's a separate issue. Not going to talk too much about other like monk design otherwise. But we have the human monk, Sibba. We have the other intended to be main character, Rhine, who is a orcish. I don't know if she's full orc or half orc, but she's an orcish beastmaster ranger, and it's a custom homebrew revision of the Beastmaster. Try to get onto this highway. Using like a big swarm of rats, the swarm is really interesting because it's got a lot of perks for being a swarm. Like, the bigger the swarm is, as in the more health it has, the more extra damage it does. It's like basically immune to poison because if you try to poison a swarm like you poison a single rat, it's like, oh no, the one rat dies. So all poison damage is like kind of nullified. It's really interesting. What is... Oh. A staple. Anyway. Then we got the only character that died, Puke, the Thrycreen grappling fighter, who ended up dying. Spoilers, I guess. Then we have a Mind Flayer Scion. Okay, cool. Bus. I'm going to be late now. Oh, well. There was never a bus on this route before. I don't know why. All right. So, Thrycreen Mind Flayer, or Thrycreen Fighter, then a Mind Flayer Scion, and I'm playing a Dwarven Phantom Rogue. So, lots of, like, melee and physical damage. Mostly, it's almost entirely Marshals. And a Scionist, or Scion, whatever, that is built for basically, like, some, like, utility and control. Like, they didn't do all that much damage on their own. They did a lot of control effects, but definitely a weird kind of class. Like, they did one or two, like, pretty impactful things. But I don't know exactly how the class worked, but it seemed like, as far as I could tell, it really kind of seemed like they had lower resources than something like a wizard. But I think, like, they function with, like, something called psi points, where the same thing as key points, basically. Like, they fuel stuff, and they come back on short rest. So, of course, they're going to seem to have lower resources based on just, like, a single quick dungeon crawl. Because we didn't get a short rest in between, so the character couldn't recover any resources, blah, blah, blah. Then, yeah, so we don't really have any area damage. We don't have any healing. We just have a bunch of dudes with weapons and a squid guy. So, the way this session went, and as with any spotlight, everyone else kind of takes a back seat. Like, you know, we roleplay our characters and we have, quote, the fun. But the spotlight, the central focus character, is effectively, like, in charge on a meta level. Like, we all know, like, okay, this character's in charge. It's their spotlight. We're going to let them do what they want to do. So, quick play-by-play of it and of what essentially happened. That we got teleported to this, like, mountain or desert kind of fortress type thing. We know there's ninjas in there. We got to kill this one guy. So we go in and we go to, like, the front desk. Sibba punches the clerk in the face, just starts a fight, and kind of decides, like, okay, we're just going to walk in the front door and bust some heads. Okay, cool. Well, I can work with that. We go in, puke in the Thrycreen fighter, and immediately peels off and separates himself. And spoilers, we never see him again, basically. He peels off and he goes around, which is, going around is actually the way we should have gone, like, snuck in. But main character wants to go in through the front door. Like, okay, cool, we're going to fight a bunch of ninjas. That's what we're here for. So we go in, we fight a bunch of ninjas. It's a relatively close fight because we're fighting, like, I don't know, 10 ninjas? And they all do sneak attack and extra poison damage with a con save. So, it was pretty rough. It was relatively rough, but we pulled it out in the first fight. It was just the four of us, and the Thrycreen fighter just peeled off and was, like, looking around on their own, taking out dudes one at a time, more or less. Doing pretty well for themselves. They never got hit during this sequence. But, so we finished those fights up, and the main group is, like, looking around, investigating, finding some stuff. We talked to a boar guy, and then Sibba peels off and effectively goes after Puke, but doesn't tell the rest of the group what we're doing. And the thing about this party is we're all effectively loners that is used to working alone. So we kind of make it a point to not go out of our way for teamwork. And that ends up biting us in the ass. Because the three of us, or the three largest group, my dwarf, the Mind Flayer, and the Ranger, we're, like, looking around, we're, like, going in the main entrance, we find more ninjas. Then the Monk and the Thrycreen, they end up finding the big boss. They run into him. And the DM has said to us afterwards, well, during, actually, that this boss was obviously intended for us all to fight at the same time. And after seeing how it went down, yeah, that would have been fine. If we were all fighting at the same time, that would have been great. It would have been a perfectly fine fight without really much risk of us losing it, unless more ninjas showed up. Then it would have been more complicated, but otherwise, we would have been fine fighting that guy. Then simply we get worn down on both fronts because we're fighting so many dudes. We're trying to get back together, but there's walls in the way. My character can face through the walls, so I try to help out a little bit, but then my attention keeps getting pulled all over. A bunch of us go down. Puke ends up dying. But then we retreat, because one character's dead. There's no way we can pull the situation out. Like, we don't have anybody that can do big area damage to try to take out a bunch of ninjas at once. We don't have anything like that. The control caster is out of resources. Everybody's at low HP, except for the dwarf, because for some reason my characters always, have the most HP. I don't know why, unless I'm Morsier, but... So, kind of mission failed moment. And after talking about it with the group, going over some stuff, there's a few things we noticed. One, the ranger, and to a lesser extent, the monk, the spotlight character, they seem to have weird equipment. Mostly because, one player helped the ranger with their equipment and kind of never finalized it because Roll20 was being weird. But they have a whole... 10k gold to spend on equipment that's just sitting there. So obviously that's something we're going to go over. Then the monk also has some weird stuff. They don't really have any combat items, because the DM did take a look at their sheet and point out some items. But we're back in town. This is a chance to kind of regroup, re-equip ourselves, and just kind of get back into it. That kind of thing. So that's something we're gonna do. But I think, and this is this is gonna be a thought based on how different my DM style is versus Chief, the DM of this game. Something I would have done, and because this is how I design my encounters and adventures, I would have looked at first of all, I barely use any pre-made stat blocks. I would have looked at what's the average damage of the party? Okay, the dwarf does, he has a +2 heavy crossbow, and his sneak attack is 7d6. So he's doing, an average of 5.5 plus 7. 5.5 plus 7. Plus 7d6 is, 25-ish. So he's doing an average of 38, almost 40 damage a turn to a single dude when he's getting sneak attack. So that's his average damage. Then the monk is doing an average of 4.5 plus 5, 3 times with no resources, 4 times with resources, and then adding an extra, 3 or 4... It's 4.5 plus wisdom, so I don't know exactly how high their wisdom is. Probably a 16 or so. But so that's an extra, whatever. So monk resource damage is 38 plus another 7, whatever. 6 or 7, so... around 40, around the same as the rogue. So we'll just say the average damage for those two characters is 40. Okay. So I'd probably put a single ninja's HP around 40. Depending on how many of them there are, I'd put it lower. So we're almost guaranteed to take out a single ninja in a single attack. the monk using resources and the rogue getting sneak attack, which sneak attack's not hard to get. But the idea is we would be taking out a single ninja with an attack. That's a little more kind of power fantasy, but it's also those two characters would be taking out ninjas. Damn. Taking out ninjas with a single attack. But the ranger would not, because the ranger was doing an average of like two attacks for like 11, or no, less than 11, like 9 damage average. Plus the rat, and plus the rats are doing like, I don't know, I'm going to be generous, 14 damage, 15 damage, something like that per turn, like when they hit. So the ranger's doing like an average of 10 damage, or almost like around 30, we'll say, to be generous. So the mind flayer is doing like definitely not that much without resources. So yeah, putting the HP of a single ninja at like 35, I think would make sense if I were the designing the encounter, because then the players could have, you know, just fought their way through. But that's mostly, I like to make like any kind, like a variety of path through an adventure possible. But this is also a late game adventure, and I've only designed earlier game stuff, so there's a little bit different philosophies there. But maybe I'll talk more about that kind of idea later. Really, this particular party just needs like some actual teamwork, and that's something we're gonna be going over definitely. But yeah, and otherwise, you know, I want to reiterate, there's no like hard feelings because we failed or anything. I'm not gonna blame anyone for that. Like, you know, the two characters that peeled off, they were playing to their characters, and we paid for it. But that's kind of the point. That's how it works. Finding that balance of what your character would do and what makes sense to do. But yeah, that's all I got today.